Hey guys, welcome back in Codespear. So today in this video, I will show you that how you can implement custom progress bar in your Android app. So guys, as you can see on the screen that when I will click on this button 1, progress bar 1, so you can see that this is a progress bar 1 and now it is showing. And when I will click on this button 2, so you can again see that this is a progress bar 2. Fine. So today in this tutorial, in this video, I will show you that how you can do this, how you can implement these two progress bar in your Android app. So without wasting time, let's start. So guys, what is the first thing that here we will do is we will create XML file. So guys, you can see that our root layout is constant layout and we don't need to change it. After this guys, we will use a linear layout inside it, and that width will be match parent, height will be wrap content, fine, and its orientation will be vertical, fine guys. Then after this, what you have to do is we are going to use two buttons inside this layout. So simply write button, and that will be match parent, wrap content, and text will be progress bar 1. Fine guys, then ID it will be p1 done, then margin will be 3dp, then guys simply close it, fine. Then copy this button simply, and then guys you have to paste it again, and this time we will change its ID to p2 and text to progress bar 2, fine. And then guys, after this what you have to do is simply switch to this design section and choose this linear layout, fine, and then simply fix its constant. Yeah, so it is done, that's all, fine. So now you can see that we have these two buttons. So after this guys, what we have to do here is we are going to, let me simply close this linear layout, because now we have to create a card view. So simply write card view, and it will be wrap content, and inside it card corner radius will be around 50 dp for complete circular, fine. Then guys, ID will be card view simply, then visibility it will be, now we will make it visible, later we will make it gone, fine guys. And after this what you have to do is simply let me close this. Inside it guys, we will use a progress bar, and that will be wrap content, and we will give it margin will be, we can say 8 dp will be fine. Then guys, what you have to do is simply close it. Then guys, simply again switch to this design section, and now again we will fix its constraint. So simply choose this card view and then fix it, done. Then here we have to give margin from the top, and that will be 30 dp. Then enter. Oops, 30. Let me give it 30. Fine. So guys, now you can see that we have created our XML file, and now it is complete. So here what we are using, that we are using two buttons, one card view and a progress bar, a simple progress bar, fine. Then guys, after this you have to make its visibility gone. Done. So now you can see that it is invisible, and yeah, now everything is invisible, fine guys. So now what we have to do is we will create a layout file. Layout resource file for second progress bar, and that will be progress bar 2, or you can say progress underscore layout, enter, done guys. So after this what we have to do here is we will simply use a linear layout, as you can see that it is already given, fine. Then what we have to do is simply change its orientation to horizontal. Then yeah, after this what we have to do is we will come inside this layout, and guys here we need to use a progress bar, and its width will be simply wrap content, and height will be 100 dp. You may be thinking why I'm giving 100 dp, so I will explain it later. That is a very simple process, simply give it ID, and ID is going to be, I think we don't need ID, yeah, because we have nothing to do with it. Then guys, after this, what you have to do is layout margin right, and that will be 30 dB. Done. Then simply close it. And then guys, after this, we will use a text view, and that is going to be again width should be wrap content and height should be 100 dB. Again, fine. Then text will be processing, or we can give loading, you can give whatever you want, it just depends on you. I'm just showing you a demo. Fine. So text size will be 30 SP. fine. Then guys, text color should be Android black. I think it will look little bit better. And then guys, what we have to do is gravity will be center, so it will make it in center. So now you can see that we'll give text style also, it will bold. So yeah, now it is looking not pretty. Yeah, it's fine, I think. So after this, you have to give you have to go inside this linear layout, and guys, here you have to give gravity, and that will be center. Fine. Now after this, you have to make its height simply wrap content. Yeah, so now you can see that how it is looking. So that is all for this. Yeah, that is all for this progress layout.xml file. Done guys. So after this, what you have to do is guys, we need to create one more Java class, and that will be for our this progress layout. So simply give this Java class name is loading bar. Fine. Then enter. Then guys, what you have to do here is after creating this method loading bar, we will create a constructor, and that will be, first of all, we will initialize some activity, right? Activity and also alert dialog, because we will need it later. Alert dialog, then dialog semicolon. Fine guys, then here you have to do is simply create a constructor, and that will be loading bar, and the parameter will be activity, and this time it will be this activity. Fine. So yeah, after this, what you have to do is simply write activity, and then we will simply initialize it, this activity. Done guys. So after this, go outside this, and here we will create a method, and that is going to be show dialog. Fine. And then simply start, then alert dialog dot builder equals to builder equals to new alert dialog builder, and here we will pass that activity. Fine guys, then semicolon, and after this you have to write is layout inflator, because we have to fix the custom layout resource file that we are generating for the custom progress bar. Fine guys, so simply write inflator, and then equals to activity dot get layout inflator, and then semicolon. Done. Then simply write inflator dot set, sorry, we are not going to use inflator, we have to write builder dot set view. Fine. Then inside it we will write inflator dot inflate, and that is going to be r dot layout for the id, and then here we have to write progress layout. You can see it is a progress layout resource file that we have generated. Then after this, you have to pass the null for attaching to root, then semicolon, and then you have to write one more line, builder dot set cancelable. So what it will do guys, that it will cancel the progress bar when you will click anywhere on the screen, but I think we will use handler, so we don't need it. Yeah, simply, so after this you have to write dialog, then equals to builder. Guys, these two lines are very important, because it will create the dialog, and dialog dot show. Fine guys, then go outside this method, and again you have to create one more for canceling that bar. Fine. So simply write dismiss bar, then inside it we will simply write dialog dot dismiss. Done. So guys, that is all for this Java class, and now guys, it is time to come inside this main activity dot Java, and here what we will do is simply declare variables for button and card view. So write button, this will be p1 and p2 semicolon, then card view, and that will be card view semicolon. Then guys, come inside this onCreate method, and here we will guys give reference fine. So simply write p1 and that will be equals to find view by id r dot id dot p1 semicolon, then p2 equals to find view by id r dot id dot p2 then semicolon fine, then card view equals to find view by id r dot id dot card view done. So after this guys, what we have to do is we have to initialize that class. So simply write final, and that will be loading bar, loading bar equals to new loading bar, and here guys we will pass main activity as the parameter fine, then dot this, then semicolon done guys. So after this we will implement set on click listener method for the button. So simply write p1.set on click listener method dot new, then on click listener method fine. So inside it guys, what we will do is that we will simply make the card view dot set visibility, it will be visible done, and then we will use a handler. So after 5 seconds it will simply dismiss, it will simply make it invisible fine. So simply write new handler, then semicolon, and then guys here you have to do is handler dot post delayed, it will be new, then runnable done, and guys here we will give a time of 5 seconds. So after 5 seconds it will make it invisible. So what we here we have to do, card view dot set visibility gone, we will make it gone. When you will make it invisible, so it will leave some space in that layout in the screens, and we don't want it. So simply write gone done, then set on click listener method, then new, then on click listener method. And again guys, here what we are going to do is simply write loading bar dot show dialog fine, then semicolon, it already have. And then after this again we are going to use handler, then handler equals to new, then handler, handler semicolon, then handler dot post delayed, and that will be again new runnable. And again here guys we will give the time of 5 seconds. So now what we need to do is loading bar dot dismiss bar done guys. So that is all for this. Now I think our coding part is almost complete, so it's time to run. So guys, it is time to run the app and see is it working or not. So in case if you get any error, then let me know in comment section, I will try to reply in next 24 hours. So guys, you can see that our app is running, and now you can see that we have this two bars, I mean we have these two buttons. So if I will click on this progress bar one, so you can see that this is a progress bar and now it is visible, and after 5 seconds it will become invisible fine. And when I will click on this progress bar two, so you can see that this is a custom progress bar second and it is showing loading fine. So you can see that it is working absolutely fine, there is no kind of error. If I will click on progress bar two, so you can see this progress bar, and if I will click on the progress bar one, so you can see that it is working also absolutely fine. So guys, today in this tutorial, I hope you like this tutorial. So please like, share, and guys do subscribe my channel, because every time someone subscribe my channel, it gives me a reason to create more interesting and useful content for Android development. So make sure you subscribe my channel and please press the bell icon so you will never miss any update. So thank you for watching.